We go to meteorologist Michelle Muscatello. Good morning, Michelle. How are you?
Good morning, Steve. We're good. We're tracking some fog this morning and some showers moving through. Want to start with the pick of the day. This is a nicer view here as we look out from James, Mandeville, and Lincoln. Nice shot there. We have not so good visibility as you travel. Providence points south this morning, and the radar also picking up on showers that have been making their way towards the coastline over Jamestown, parts of Newport this morning, moving over towards Buzzards Bay. We have more downpours that are crossing Nantucket and Martha's Vineyard this morning as well. And as we look back to our south and west, these showers continuing here for especially the morning hours, and then should become a little spottier in the afternoon. I mean, just starting July, like we ended June, unfortunately, which is unsettled. It ended up being the second wettest June on month. Once we tallied the rainfall over the weekend, we ended up with just over 10 inches of rain and exactly an inch shy of the all-time record, which was 11.08 inches set back in 1982. So a wet month, it looks like we'll start off today, tomorrow, especially with a wet July, and then we'll bring down those rain chances just in time for the 4th. 72 in Smithfield right now. It's 72 in Providence, 71 in New Bedford. Look at the visibility out on Block Island. You've got those showers moving over, fog as well. Down to about a mile visibility in Newport, a quarter mile westerly, a half a mile for your visibility in Providence, and 7 miles as you travel further north into Smithfield and Pawtucket. As we look at satellite and radar, you can see line of heavy downpours just training over eastern Pennsylvania, New York, northwestern New Jersey. The showers for our area again clipping us, especially this morning, then becoming a little spottier as we head later into the day. This is at 9 o'clock this morning, so still some passing showers for a few of us at 2 o'clock in the afternoon. There'll be some dry time in between later on this evening and tonight, maybe even a little peak of hazy sun late in the day like we've seen the last couple of days. Overnight tonight, more fog, a passing shower. Tomorrow, the rain chances go down a little bit. I think it'll be a little bit spottier, and we'll see still that isolated shower, thunderstorm popping up as we head, especially late in the day. So fog and a passing shower this morning, 69 to 74 temperature wise through the later morning. Well, once we dry things out, those temperatures will try to climb into the upper 70s to lower 80s by 1:30, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. 79 in Warwick, low to mid 70s along the coastline. Smithfield at 77 this evening and tonight. We're in the 70s. We'll stay that way right through the nighttime hours. So 10:30 at night, it's about 73 degrees, and then staying around 70 degrees for the late night low. Another warm and humid day tomorrow, despite clouds, some hazy sun, shower, thunderstorm around in spots, about 83 degrees. Wednesday, so here's where we start to turn the corner. High pressure will start to build back towards us. It's a Bermuda high pressure. It's going to keep the heat and humidity around, but it'll lower our rain chances. They'll become a little bit more predictable, more towards the late part of the day in the evening, about 8 to 10. PM for fireworks displays Wednesday evening, hazy and humid, about 74 to 78. We'll see some fog Thursday morning for your 4th of July morning, and then hazy, hot and humid, about the mid to upper 80s away from the coastline on Thursday. Just a very small chance of an isolated thunderstorm Thursday through the weekend. The heat and the humidity, though, will be building.